Name is Hardman Williams, and I'm with AT&T, and I'm just so thankful and grateful to Forrest and the INROADS leadership team for inviting me here for this iconic milestone, which is the INROADS 50th. I've had the benefit of being a part of the INROADS family for over 30 years. I was an intern back in the early to late 80s and had the opportunity to join AT&T as a part of INROADS and haven't looked back. So I'm here today because I was given the opportunity to talk about how AT&T is thinking about communities and being disruptively innovative. I'm super proud to have been given an opportunity to lead our community work. We're a fortunate company, but at our heart, we are the 240,000 plus employees that help us manifest good in these communities. So I'm thrilled to talk to you today about AT&T Believes, and I look forward to the conversation. So let me start with a little bit of context, and I'm gonna do it in the form of a story. Chicago, Illinois, one of the most tremendous cities in the country. I had the honor of living there for 10 years. This was the innovative birthplace of AT&T Believes. We've been in these communities for over 100 years, but these employees back in the third quarter of 2018 took a very entrepreneurial approach to community activation. These employees took a very, very different approach and boldly stepped forward and said, the most essential and germane issue for us as employees is the neighborhood violence that we're seeing in the south side of Chicago. And so for them, they narrowed that lens and said, look, let's come together with collaborators in the community who have a core competency in this work. Let's marry our employees to that effort and do something that is fairly material in those markets. The point was, they live in those communities, they work in those communities, and as such, they really felt that they wanted to believe in that community. And thus, the notion of AT&T Believes was born in what was then Believe Chicago. So this model that our employees in Chicago came up with in Believe Chicago caught fire, and other communities across the country started to really get engaged. We are now a modern media company, and we have lots of assets through Warner that are in Los Angeles. The Los Angeles employee base said, we want Believe LA to be about helping youth who are interested in media. And so they built Believe LA to improve diversity in front of the camera and behind the camera. And then if you look at where we are in our headquarters in Dallas, Believe Dallas is all about mitigating homelessness. And the notion of that came from the fact that we are investing in a brand new campus in downtown Dallas. And so the Dallas team really galvanized around homeless mitigation and have partnered with many, many different homeless service providers here in the Dallas area to try to provide a positive impact in that work. Finally, the work was so credible domestically that our international employees became excited and engaged around AT&T Believes. And so as 2019 finished, we had some 35 plus what we call Believe franchises, all with their own unique focus and charter. And we moved into 2020, and our international teams continued to clamor for their opportunity to participate in this model. And we were just able to launch internationally in Believe Czech Republic and Slovakia. And so those two countries came together, and we're so excited now that the brand has a credible presence internationally in Central Europe. We entered 2020 with great aspirations. Then, like the rest of the world, we're hit with this unprecedented pandemic. And when you look inside of this pandemic and look at the disproportionate impact it had on people of color, we felt like we needed to step forward. And so all of the AT&T Believes franchises kind of coalesced and came together to try to provide services and support to communities during this unprecedented pandemic. The second big step in 2020, which was clearly something that we had not anticipated, was what happened when all of our franchises saw the unfortunate and really difficult situations of racial inequity in communities, especially as it relates to what we saw with George Floyd, Breonna Taylor, Ahmaud Arbery, and others. And once again, all of our franchises came together to have a very cohesive approach. And on July 30th, we are very proud that we announced $10 million in contributions for underserved, for black and brown communities. About $5.5 million of those dollars will go through AT&T Belize, through collaborators that we work with in these markets to help these communities heal and to help grow financial literacy for our youth, to help provide paths for career readiness and for small businesses trying to get back to a place of vitality. We're offering opportunities for them to get access to capital. So we're super pleased that in spite of what was an extraordinarily challenging situation from the pandemic to then these circumstances of racial inequality, AT&T Believes was elastic enough, it was disruptive enough, it was entrepreneurial enough where it could step in and make a difference in both of these circumstances. So as we were navigating this difficult situation that was 2020, we had to look at a disruptive, innovative way for our employees to become involved. Clearly, they could not go into communities physically and engage in the way that they had done before. And so our team really thought about this and came together and put together a whole new platform of virtual approaches that they can use to engage in communities. And they thought about it along a wide continuum of activities, whether there was a light touch version of just digitally engaging with our communities, like writing a note online to underserved students in various communities, and or a really more immersive model that we built last year called AT&T Believes at Home, where it really mimics the sort of engagement and interaction that you'd have at a physical volunteer location. So we're super proud that we now have virtual as a second business model for volunteering. And we think that that disruption really was a landmark for how we'll think about engaging communities going forward. So I mentioned earlier our work here in the headquarters in Dallas and how it's focused on trying to mitigate some of the impacts of homelessness. Candidly, if you look at the statistics around homelessness, it's growing more than any of us would ever want to tolerate. It's grown almost 300% here in Dallas over the last few years. And more troubling is if you look inside of those statistics and the populace that's being impacted by homelessness, nearly 70% of them are black here in Dallas. And that certainly didn't sit well with us. And so we really wanted to do something about it. And so we talked about this formula of having a specific cause or charter, bringing in collaborators that can help you with this disruptive model, and then bringing our employees in to make a difference. And so if you apply that particular algorithm to what we've done in Believe Dallas, we worked with one of the homeless solution providers here named Our Calling. And the head of Our Calling is a wonderful, wonderful person who's technically a technologist by trade. And they had a fairly simple app that they had released to help curate services for the homeless community. They came to us and said, "You're a technology company. We'd love to elevate the app and refine it such that it is more useful and productive for those suffering from homelessness." And so we turned to our millennial employees, and they stepped forward in a big, big way. And so we had a team of technologists who came together in a very, very short period of time. These great young employees literally coded a brand new app platform, got it released in both app ecosystems, and now you've got an opportunity for Our Calling where that app platform is being used globally. It's being open sourced and people can provide input to service locations all around the globe for the purposes of helping and mitigating homelessness. And so that's a great example of how you can bring forward the power and the intensity of our millennial employees and how they made a really, really important impact to the homeless situation that we see here in Dallas. So in close, I'm super excited that AT&T Believes can stand as a framework for disruptive social good. But at the same time, my personal reflections on this role have been immense. I grew up in the inner city, saw many of these challenges that these communities see, had the great fortune of being involved with organizations like INROADS to help provide me development and candidly give me an aspiration for a place that I wouldn't typically have seen where I was growing up. And so for me, this has been an extraordinary opportunity for me to provide some reciprocity back to communities that are being impacted negatively in a similar way in which I saw as a young person. So as I look forward to what the Believe brand will do here going forward, it's also an opportunity for me to invest personally into making impact in these communities of color. Thank you for giving me the opportunity to share my story, share the disruptive approach that we're trying to take with AT&T Believes. Congratulations to INROADS on 50 years, and I wish you all a great event.